You know, this you mentioned ahead of us, they might be ahead of us. Very beautiful story and amazing, and it's really under this context that you're mentioning. Nabiullah Musa, alayhi wa ala nabina wa alihi afdhalus salatu wa salam, Moses, he was asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to him, the next time that you come to me, bring with you someone or something that you think you are better than. Nabiullah Musa said, okay. Now this is Nabiullah Musa, and he's of Ulul Azm. He's a Rasul, a messenger, so that puts him in a higher ranking. Not only that, he's of Ulul Azm, so he's the highest of the prophets.
Very interesting prophet.
Definitely.
Most mentioned story in the whole history. Very definitely. Important prophet.
Now, you'd imagine someone like him would come and he'll be able to pick anyone and just come in. He saw someone on the street. He said, do you know what? I'm the prophet. Definitely better than this person. He said, no, hold on a second. I don't know what is between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he didn't bring him. Then it mentions of him saying, then he said, just to shorten the story, then he said, do you know what? The easiest thing is for me to bring an animal. Now let me think, what is one of the worst of animals I can bring with me? He saw a dog. He said, do you know what? Let me bring this dog. Now not only is it a dog, it mentions kalbun aqur. Aqur is like, it has an illness to it. So it's not only is it a dog, but it's an ill dog. So he said, most definitely I must be better than this creation. So then he was about to take it, then he said, no, hold on a second. Maybe this dog did something that was so high in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it might be even better than me. So then he went back.
Did he mean like as in he was inflicted with that illness and that was sort of Allah's way of sort of testing him?
No, he meant as in maybe there was an action. So for example, maybe one time he saw a puppy on the street, as an example, and he saved the puppy for the dog. Sure. So a specific action that he did. So he said, you know what? I don't know that. I don't know what's been going on through the life of this dog. He went back. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you didn't bring anyone with you. He said to him, oh Allah, I do not know what is in the heart of of all the creatures that I was looking at. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied to him. He said, if you had brought anything with you, I would have, you know, not taken away nubuwwah. No, لَنَزَعْتُهَا عَنْكِ. يعني, you know when you have clothes on and you take the clothes off? He says, I would have taken prophethood, I would have taken it off from you. And it just shows the beauty of, this is a prophet that we're talking about. We don't know what is between. I don't know what you guys do at home. You don't know what I do at home. I might be reciting dua here, but I might be doing something else when I'm out of the studio. You never know. So this having ideas of people trying to pinpoint certain stuff, very wrong.
And I think, you know, when we talk a lot about connection in the holy month of Ramadan, and we say about spirituality, and you know, in essence, spirituality is the self-refinement of yourself, and you can only look at your own actions and know, you know, have a record of where you are compared to where you were yesterday or the year last year. Like, how was our holy month last year? Have we made improvements? And spirituality is not about, you know, looking at others and saying, well, I'm doing better than you. You know, it's really about in reflection. And this month, I mean, when you're reciting the du'as, you know, again, it reminds you of the greatness of Allah. Who are we going to face that day on, you know, Qiyamah?
100%.
That are our deeds good enough to be showing ourselves, saying, you know, I'm a believer. And it's so important to be, you know, looking inwards.